Well, that don't look like too bad of a list. We already swept the shop floors, so let's move outside and we'll show you what we got to do. Remember I told you the inside of the packing blew apart on that cylinder? Well, we got it in here, and sure enough, the packing was blown down to the cylinder. Brand new cylinder here from Shoup Farm Equipment. They do outstanding work. This one's got a much better seal on it. It just goes right here, right up there with these bolts on each end. One there, put the new one there. I guess they give you new hardware. It's sweet. So you have fun with this. Get to work. Well, this isn't what I wanted to have happen this time of year. Although it is November 1st, it's about 40 degrees out. With the wind blowing about probably 3 mile an hour or so. Yeah, wasn't really expecting the coveralls this early. I was expecting to throw them on more towards like the middle of the month, not at the beginning. But it is what it is. I think it Heston's in here. I think it is. Daggone, it is right there next to the 4020. All right, so I got a couple requests for a couple cold start videos. I'm not, I was into cold starts and that, and not anymore. It just not my thing. Why would you want to start a tractor just to hear it cackle and cough and spit and sputter and puke and everything else, and then shut it right back off? I used to be that kind of a person, I'm not gonna lie. But I'm going to demonstrate the right way how to start a tractor when it's cold. Stay tuned, guys. Okay, so with this tractor here, it's a Fiat or a Heston 566. Somewhere is around 70-80 horsepower, I believe. I'm not sure. I'm going to show you the right way to start this booger. Now, on these Hestons, I'm not. All I know is you gotta give her all the fuel she wants. So you got to push that pedal all the way open or the hand throttle. And then when she starts coughing and cackling and puking and spitting and sputtering, then you just shove that throttle right about 1,000 RPMs or so till she warms up. So I'm gonna show you guys how the heck we do this. Or I do it. And maybe I'll learn something from you YouTubers. Let it sit here and warm up for a little bit. Now, it's also that time of year where we get stuff put away. We won't be needing the mower anymore, I don't think. So we'll get this John Deere started. Let it sit here and warm up. Now, since this is the last thing that I started, I'll put that Heston on the pig mover. It's over there. I'll put it on the pig mover first since it was the first thing to get started. Since this is the last thing to get started, it'll sit here and warm up while I put that pig mover on. Totally different tractor. This being John Deere. I'm not sure what kind of an engine. It's a 7200 series. But, turn the radio off. Turn the fan off because it just helps the cranking. Batteries. Okay. Now the water's not that cold, or the engine. oxygen, I mean, that's just water temperature. It's not that cool, but I'm still gonna let it sit in here and warm up. Just for the oils and stuff, that's what we do. Cross the road, let the off-road trucks, the loaders and all that sit there and warm up for a few minutes. Run the beds up and down, that kind of stuff. Get that oil nice and circulating, get it operating temperature. Okay, I think that Heston ought to be warmed up by now. Tarp strap off of here so that it spreads these out. Have to go back up one so it sucks them in. Just a hair. There. Now we need to come back a little bit. Third time's a charm, guys. Not knocking Heston or Fiat or anything like that. But I wish they'd learned from John Deere to make these halfway point here, make these a telescopic link or telescopic pole arms rather than just a solid piece. I don't know what the thinking was when they made that. Top links can get confusing at times with how they go. The threads here and there. It's just confusing to me. Well, my tractor's still running, so that's a good thing. Okay, so 1994? 95? I don't know, but it's getting tired. It's got, what's it got for hours? Let's see. 5,200 hours. That's not bad. Give every farmer respect that farms or does farm or is currently farming with an open station tractor. Maybe that's what you can afford or what was given to you, handed down from your grandfathers or whoever. I'm not knocking you or bashing you one way. I know for Bandit Farmer, I watch his stuff. He's had a few people knock him and bash him. Go check out Bandit Farmer if you do. And he's come to the point where he said, enough is enough. Quit bashing me about what I farm or how I farm or what I do. This is the way we farm in Northeast Ohio, and we use big equipment. Well, okay, not big equipment to some farmers, but we use what we use, and that's it. You that's hooked these brush hogs up, know that you gotta be so darn strict with them when you go to hook them up that you can't be on even the slightest little bit of an angle. There's what I got to work with. So, I guess what I have to do is kind of back my way in here at a sharp angle, and then, man, still can't get it. To the test here. What just happened? That tongue don't look right. Is this supposed to do that? Huh. Never seen it do that before. All I need to do is be able to get back into that tongue and just by turning the wheel, I should be able to throw that drawbar wherever I want. Like that. Okay. Let's see, pull ahead a little bit. I can't get with this corn head here. My dilemma is it's hitting the stupid hook here. This thing here, it's hitting a piece of junk. Actually, it's not a piece of junk. That's where I think it's where the safety thing goes, the chain. But I can't hook up on an angle like this. You got to be darn straight, like I was talking about earlier. Move that combine, I think. I really want to start a cold engine. Make sure there's nothing back behind me. I only need to go back maybe 2 foot. Then I can get it the more hooked up. Because I can't get it right where it is. Oh, that's right. Listen to that thing low. I think I shut the door. There. Okay, now I can do my job better. I'll never be able to get in here with that corn head the way my combine up here as close as it was. Proof you can't be on a little bit of an angle. We didn't need to hook none of the hydraulics or the PTO up. That darn thing, it takes 2 men and a boy to lift it. But we'll get it all washed off here and put it in a shop. So I assume we're gonna... yeah, these are dough. Yep. They're dull. Corn stalks really do a number on them. Looks better and feels a lot better too.